Hi, I'm Cristina Prall. In this video, I'll discuss the difference between reflecting and retracting muscles, how to clean neurovasculature, and how to tell the difference between nerves, arteries, and veins. Let's take a look. Oftentimes while dissecting, muscles will need to be reflected or retracted in order to find deep neurovasculature. Retracting a muscle means to move the muscle from one side to another in order to view what lies deep to it, but without cutting the muscle. Reflecting a muscle means to actually cut the muscle at one or more attachment points, leaving one or more attachments intact so as to reflect the muscle. So in this case, we have sartorius muscle, and I'm going to cut it at its proximal attachment. And reflect the muscle inferiorly. You may come across some points where fascia or the nerves that are innervating the muscle remain attached, and we can go ahead and snip that in order to continue reflecting the muscle out of our way. Now that sartorius muscle has been reflected, we can see a bundle of neurovasculature that lies deep to it, and that's going to be the femoral artery, vein, and nerve. Here we're looking at the arm, where the neurovasculature is typically significantly smaller than the neurovasculature found in the lower limb. Blunt dissection is always used to clean arteries, nerves, and veins. A probe, forceps, or the closed tips of scissors can be used to scrape fat and fascia off of the neurovasculature bundle. You can also use the dull edges of the scissor blades to poke and spread throughout that fascia. Sometimes it can be tricky to differentiate between arteries, veins, and nerves in the lab, especially as the structures branch or course distally. Arteries and veins have a lumen through which blood flows, so when you touch the structure, you can feel the lumen collapse beneath your fingers. So here we have an artery, and you can see the walls give in beneath pressure. And similarly, you can see the same for the vein here. Whereas if we were to press or feel a nerve, you wouldn't feel any walls collapse because nerves are solid. Typically, arteries don't appear as blue as veins because veins have thin walls that allow you to see through to the blood within. Arteries have much thicker walls, and it's not as easy to see the blood, and therefore they typically appear more white in color. Due to the histological makeup of arteries and veins, arteries look and feel more robust and round, while veins have thin walls and are often collapsed in the donor. Typically, not always, arteries tend to take a more curvy or tortuous path, whereas nerves tend to be a little more flat and straight. Now again, this is not always the case, but it's a pretty common indicator in lab. As a reminder, only blunt dissection is ever used for cleaning neurovasculature. In the next video, I'll give some dissection tips on cutting bone.